Gemini, welcome to your weekly reading. This is going to be for the sign of Gemini. It's not going to resonate with every single one of you out there. This is also not Sun, Moon, or Venus sign specific. Any Gemini placement you resonate with, some of the messages may also resonate with you. Any jewelry seen, personal reading information will be all linked and listed. At the end, we will pull some oracles, give you a little bit more guidance for the week. Otherwise, here we go, Gemini. I do only take jumpers. Appreciate your patience in advance. All right, first card out is the Ten of Swords, followed by the Queen of Wands. Fire sign energy here. Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius could be important to you. We also have the Five of Wands. We also have Temperance, Major Arcana for Sagittarius energy. The King of Pentacles and the Knight of Pentacles. So lots of fire and lots of earth. Those two signs could be significant, or someone with those elements. You could have that in your chart, the bottom of the deck. Major Arcana, the Hangman, Pisces energy. Some sort of stagnancy here. Something's moving very slow. It seems like it's moving very slow. Something to do with patience here as well. Patience is required for whatever this next period or this next week is going to bring in for you. I do see some sort of drama around you here. Things are getting ready to change. Okay? I don't feel like it's necessarily you directly, but around you. If you can see how the cards are set up. Some drama going on around her. She's kind of on the outside looking in. I do see you coming in as this Queen of Wands, whether you're fire in your chart or not. Very magnetic, very creative, very intuitive. And I do see there's a lot going on around you that either some you're aware of and some you're not aware of. Some of you are ending something, and because you're ending something, that's going to create a lot of issues elsewhere with other people. Also could be a lot of people that want your attention. A lot of people want your time. A lot of people want your energy. But I think you're focused on your money here, it feels like. You're focused on stability. Maybe creating more streams of income, making sure you have that Christmas money. I do see a King of Pentacles here. This King of Pentacles could also be someone outside of you that has been moving very slowly towards something. Maybe it's a job that's slow to sort of give you a raise. Or there's some sort of something with money here that's moving slow for somebody. Whether it's you or someone you're connected to, it might not be you at all. It's almost like there's a lot of shit going on around you. And maybe it's a time to be patient. Maybe it's a time to sort of sit back. The way that I see you sort of doing, it's not time to jump in yet. Because there's something that you need to see here. Through observing, that's where the message is. Through observing, don't get involved in people's ish. Because it looks like shit's kind of going on for people around you. Maybe not you so much, but maybe the ones you love, right? Yeah, you're sitting pretty. Mm-hmm, you're solid. Nine of Pentacles. Very feminine energy, whether you're masculine or feminine. You're kind of just allowing things to happen. And I think that's the best way to go, because it does look like there are a lot of things going on. Some people are having money issues. Some people are, there's some drama. You might have ended situations and left some people in the dust. And I do see a sense of you needing patience. It's like, now is not the time. For whatever it is you're thinking or wanting to do or wanting to take action on, now is not the time. You got to let the dust settle. Patience here and the Hangman. Very stagnant, slow-moving cards. And both their heads are lit up. So this could also be some sort of divine protection. If there's something that you're waiting for to go through and it's not, that's on purpose. It's not the time yet. You can very clearly see that a lot of stuff's going on around you. Some you're aware of, some you're not aware of. And it's like the dust is still kicked up. The divine doesn't want you to have anything to do with the kicked up dust. They want you to come out scot-free, scot-clean. You could also be getting bad vibes. That's why it could be taking you long to move forward with something. Because it's giving you bad vibes. Anything to do with money? Or someone that's trying to make you commit somehow? Because that black cat's looking at me like, mm-mm, you're being protected. But things are shifting. Things are definitely shifting. For some of you, it definitely has to do with work. There's drama going on within your work environment. And it's saying, just chill for a sec. Let things kind of settle down. Don't get involved in the politics. Because it looks like there is an upgrading for you coming. Once the dust settles, there is a leveling up for you. Maybe becoming the boss or taking the boss's position. Or once the dust settles, then you can take action. This could even be for investments. Maybe now is not a good time to invest in certain things. You got to kind of wait. And then once you wait, then you can take action. Because the Emperor is also action-oriented energy. Yeah. A lot of confusion going on. Yeah, something about investments. Funny, I just said investments. The Seven of Pentacles is here. Two sevens, jackpot energy too. So this is also a waiting card. So if something is not clear to you, now is not the time. Whether it's with money, whether it's relationships, whether it's loved ones, you gotta kind of leave them to their own devices. Now is not the time to make any sort of commitments in any way, shape, or form, not to work. Or now is not time to put up big, large amounts of money. Maybe even that's for somebody. Let's just move it along, because that's kind of the vibe I'm getting. It's a time to pause. Whatever move you're contemplating, it's a time to pause. Okay. Guidance for Gemini, please, if this is a love-specific situation. People you may be dealing with, an Aries, heavy on the Sagittarius energy. Pisces, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. Free yourself. It's time to take back control of your life. And that's also with that Aries, it's also a sense of control. So you definitely could have ended something. For some of you, it might be a job you've left. It could be even a relationship that you've left. One you've been in for a very long time. It looks like you finally left. Now is the time you finally left. And it's saying, don't worry about all the drama for now. It will pass. It will pass. Any sort of moves you're making, maybe you want to be a bit secretive about it. Go slow. Observe. Because there will be a time for you to pounce. But this Ten of Swords and this Free Yourself is saying there's something you have released, finally, is the vibe that I'm getting. And because you've released this thing or person or job or situation, it's completely going to put you on a new path. Some very financial, abundant, steady, stable path. But you got to let the dust settle. It's still, you know, everyone's emotions kind of still heightened. Guidance for Gemini. Sagittarius season could also be an important time frame. Believe in the impossible. Blue moon. Yeah. And I think this impossible thing is happening because you finally let go of something. Because the Ten of Swords tell me this is probably something you should have released a long time ago. And for some of you, it will be a job. For some of you, it's a group of people, friends. For some of you, it will be a relationship. Because this could also be single energy with the Nine of Pentacles. But it's definitely something you probably are long overdue on releasing. Better late than never, right? Guidance for Gemini. And if this is to do with something with money or some sort of investment, go slow, take your time, read all, you know, get as much information as you can. Wait a little bit. Because I think you're going to benefit from waiting a bit more. Guidance for Gemini. Two, okay. Where are you being called to journey to? You're definitely being led in a particular direction, creating heaven on earth. It's happening. So the shift has begun. The shift has begun, and it's meant to put you where you're meant to be, which is in some sort of leadership position, stable position, financially abundant position. But it all because you let go of something. So all the pieces are shifting now. That's also what the Temperance card is about. Divine timing. Divine intervention. Guidance for Gemini. Okay. Thank you. Squirrel spirit. Believe in yourself. Eagle spirit. Spirit has your back. Look at all the colors. Very similar. And panther spirit. Reclaim your power. Yeah, 44. You are definitely being protected. Number 23 is a 5. And number 57, which is a 12, breaks down to a 3. So definitely alignment, change, protection. You're being protected through this time of change because it looks like the change is scary. But it's saying just sit back and relax for a little bit. The divine's doing something. It's working something out for you. One card from here for Gemini, please. Some of you, it's definitely leaving a relationship behind. Free yourself and reclaim your power. You've been stuck in some sort of merry-go-round. Some sort of continuous cycle that you kept repeating. Looks like you're finally getting ready to release it. Finally. Some of it could have taken you 10 years. Okay, this one flipped out. Take some time to enjoy the things you worked hard for. So focus on yourself. Don't focus on anybody else. Let them sort of run themselves into the ground, you know? That is your reading, Gemini. Hopefully it resonates with you. Thumbs me up. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you guys next week.